Monalisa Mukherjee. Brief introduction regarding Boudhayan Mukherjee. Boudhayan Mukherjee is one of the India's leading advertisement film director, and he is very popular for his campaign against domestic violence called Bell Bajao, and he is also the founder director of the Little Lamb films. Boudhayan Mukherjee was the executive producer of the cult Bengali film Pathalgar. Apart from filmmaking, he loves writing and has been featured in a Penguin anthology. Congratulations, sir. And he is passionate about music, and he is Kahon. This is his debut as a filmmaker. The director will be making opening statement, and he will be sharing his experience with respect to the movie making and the movie which is being screened in the IFFI festival. That is the theme Kahon, sir.
Yashwant, right? Okay. Thank you, Yashwant. It's good afternoon now, not good morning. Okay, good afternoon, all of you. Thanks for making it here. This happens to be my first press conference, so you can definitely imagine the butterflies in my stomach right now. So please be gentle with the debutant filmmaker. Don't ask me questions which I don't have answers. But let me quickly introduce my team. I have Monalisa Mukherjee, who is the producer of the film.
You're welcome.
As I keep telling everyone, I sleep with my producer because she's my wife also. Okay. The other people who are here, Abhinandan Banerjee, if you can stand up and generally face them. He is my co-writer, and that's Abhinandan, and then and Kedar Barve, the Marathi executive producer of a Bengali feature film. So that's the team right now here, and I will throw the house open, and whatever questions you have about the film, I will be absolutely free to take them along with Mona.
Tell something about the film.
Okay, Theme Kahon is my debut feature. Everyone keeps asking me that, well, how has been the experience of your first feature, first film? Well, I said, well, it is actually my 321st film. I have made more than 320 commercials, so if I can count those, this possibly will be my 321st film. Yes, full-length feature for the first time, and I think it's a pat on my back when first film itself goes to Mami, where it was premiered. The India premiere happened at Mami, and then in the Indian panorama section at IFFI, which is a big moment for any debutant filmmaker in this country. Theme Kahon, as the name suggests, anyone from the Bengali press here? Okay, no. So which means that I have to explain it in great detail. Okay. Theme Kahon, as the name suggests, is Theme Kahaniya, three stories. Three stories spread over 100 years of the Bengali life. Three stories of three writers. The third one happens to be mine. The first one is a story written by Bibhutibhushan Mukhopadhyay, not Bandyopadhyay, who wrote Pathe Panchali. So let me just quickly clarify. It's Bibhutibhushan Mukhopadhyay, the first story. The second story is written by Sayyid Mustafa Siraj. And the third is mine. The three stories traverse over 100 years of the Bengali life. The first one, time period, is between 1920 and 1954. The second one is 1978. And the third one is the modern age, 2013. What we have also tried to do is that, though it was slightly unintentional when we had started off making the film, is that it turned out to be a tribute to the 100 years of Indian filmmaking. Though it was not intentional, but that's how it turned out to be. When it turned out to be, I think it came from Abhinandan, that can we now stick to the grammar of Indian filmmaking, the way Indian filmmaking has progressed over 100 years? And that's precisely what we did. We imposed, these were self-imposed do's and don'ts on us. This film was shot by Opik Mukhopadhyay. don't know if everyone has heard about him. National award-winning DOP. He has shot almost all of Ritubandhu Ghosh's film, Banti aur Babli, The Kill Dil has released right now. So Obhik Mukhopadhyay has shot it. Arghav Amal Mitra, again a national award-winning editor, has edited the film. And what we decided to do was we imposed the self-imposed do's and don'ts on the film as we made. Till such time, Subrata Mitra had invented the bounce light. We had told ourselves that Obhik will not use bounce light in the first film. In the first story, which is black and white. In the second story, by then the French wave has happened, so the camera has gone on the shoulder, so it has moved away from the tripod or the crane and track and trolley. So these were certain developments which we followed as we made the film. Pingahun got completed around July this year, and post that, this is the ninth festival we have gone to. We have already won in our European premiere at Kosovo at the Bridge Film Festival. We won the best screenplay and special mention of the jury for cinematography. At the Seattle South Asian Film Festival, we won the Audience Choice Award. So, three international awards in the kitty, nine film festivals as of now. I think for a debutant filmmaker, I couldn't have asked for more. So that, in a nutshell, it has been quite a big nutshell, I would say, is what Pingahun is all about. Now, if you have any questions, please feel free to ask.
Questions? I would like to, as the producer, ma'am, you are the producer, and working besides your husband, who is the director. How do you feel? How do you feel about that?
Well, we run the company together, which makes advertising commercials. And initially, we had decided not to work together because then you bring work home too. But then I think 1.5 years later, which is 5.5 years back, we both felt that no, it's not a 100% partnership happening. So then I full-fledgedly joined Little Lamb Films. And we've been working together, so it's fantastic because I think we are almost all the time on the same page, apart from food, completely different taste. Otherwise, we are absolutely, let me give you an example. If I'm doing costumes for him, I know exactly which ones to pick up and he will like it. So it's that close. So there's no problem at all. It's fun working together.
Ma'am, do you find any difference between making an ad film and now you are into the, the total feature film, full-length feature film?
Well, there's a huge difference because in an ad you are very precise. You're not that detailed. Less time taken, a lot of precision, a lot of more money. And in a feature film, you get time, you can detail everything. It's a different kind of fun. So ideally, you should not compare the two medium. They have their own fun ingredients to them.
And also, I also feel that
the joy takes care of the stress, so it doesn't matter.
Any questions?
Yeah, one.
Challenging was arranging, the funds, the distribution of the
money. Well, it's our own money that we put in for the film. So yes, we did not have the money, so we did the film in chunks, so we shot the first schedule, went back, earned more money, made more commercials, and then shot the second schedule, finished our money, went back, made some more commercials, earned some more money, and that's how even the post-production happened. So, good fun. So, and
which is the best one you ever had?
Sorry?
The best commercial you ever done with a big client.
It's very difficult to name one.
But still a few.
A few, Bel Bajao, of course, Bel Bajao, it's anti-domestic violence campaign that we did, which won him the silver at Cannes, and that's a series of anti-domestic violence PSAs. We've recently done a film for Coke, which is for Sri Lanka. I think it's a brilliant film. It's a brilliant, brilliant film. We do not do fashion. We do not do alcohol and other plastic, you know, the not so real life material. He's a storyteller. We do character-based, story-based films. We insist on doing those, and I think he does it very well.